Now, I discovered that there are four things about lazy people. Number one is entitlement mentality. They feel so entitled, so entitled, so entitled. And please, don't raise lazy people. What did I say? Don't sponsor laziness. Because if you sponsor laziness, you are against the protocol of God's work ethics. Jesus, when he came, he said, the Father works, I walk. He thought, I walk also. So if the Father walks and Jesus walks, why are we not walking? You see a lot of youth wasting, whiling away time. Not doing nothing. Entitlement mentality. Entitlement mentality. Number two is excuses. Those who always make excuses will be excused out of the corridor of dominion. Those who always make excuses will be excused out of the realm of glorious manifestation. Excuses. They have 1 million reasons why they have not succeeded. Why are things not working well for you? You know, not that things wouldn't have worked well. I have a lot of ideas, but nobody has agreed to help me. That was what killed Adam. When the Lord came down and said, what have you done? If Adam had told God, I am sorry for doing this, rather what Adam said, is it not the woman you gave me? If. So immediately he began to make excuses why he did it. This year, there should be no excuse. There should be no excuse. Do the most you can. Somebody say, I hear. You didn't say it loud. Say, I hear. You didn't say it loud. Say, I hear. Number three is they put blame. Lazy people, what did I say? The first one? Entitlement mentality. The second one. And then after they have made excuses, they begin to apportion blame. They start blaming their sister who got married to a rich man and has not accepted to help them. They start blaming a brother who is rich and has not agreed to help them. So they blame every other person but themselves. Are you aware that the word responsibility has three eyes in it? Three eyes. It doesn't have... It has three eyes. And one why, sir? Yes, one why. That is, that form the word letter, U. Responsibility. Three eyes, which means the first one is I'm responsible for where I am. Second one is that I only can change my destiny. So, if you take and appropriate the blame, take the blame, apportion the blame to yourself, and make a concerted effort and decision to become better. To become better. Now, if you want to exit the corridor of laziness, there is something I want you to do. There are about three things you must do. Anytime you must move from where you are to another level, you are very tired of where you have been. The first one is self-development. There must be strategic personal development. Strategic personal development. If where you are now, what you have gotten is not enough, it is because you are not yet enough. So you must build up yourself to receive what is coming. Become better. Number two is mental shift. You must begin to think differently. The first thought every lazy person must have to be able to leave laziness is to know no one is coming for your help. No one will help you. What did I say? No one is coming to help you. Yes, have you not seen it? You've seen it. You are alone on earth. You are alone. Now, it does not mean that there are no destiny helpers. But when you know that you are alone, you can begin to succeed without the... Am I talking to somebody here? And then God can start sending you help. Have you not seen that if you come into a place and the whole place is littered and everyone is sitting down, no one gets into action until one person gets into action and begins to arrange. And oftentimes, if it is what is yours, once you start arranging and making plans, putting things together, you will see other people helping you. Am I talking to somebody here? Tell somebody by your side, no one is coming for your help. What did I say? Personal development. You must develop personally. You must make it a point of duty to become a better person. Read more books. Go for more trainings. Fine-tune your singing skills. Become a better person. There must be a strategic mental shift. Strategic mental shift. Mental realignment. What is POR? P-O-O-R. Passing over opportunities repeatedly. And it is mindset that determines life setting. People pass over opportunities because of the mindset they have. Like, I got married and I told my wife, you can feed me. We were not quarreling. I said, 1,000 people like you cannot feed me. I said, it will never come to a day in your life I will depend on you to eat. It was a mindset. And somebody is saying it's because he's pastoring. It will shock you if I'm not a pastor. I will do well in business. Yes. Very well. Because business is not, there is no magic wand you need to become successful. Everything you need is in the scriptures. Everything you need is in the scriptures. Just know these principles. The principle of making up your mind, you will excel. It doesn't matter your age. As you see me here, I've made up my mind to excel. I came to this life, I know that there are people I must prove wrong. There are people who already looked at my family and see us as failures. Even the little success we are enjoying, there are people who believe we still fall. So I've made up my mind, I'm not falling. I have a lot of people to prove wrong, sir. I can't follow. A lot of people to prove wrong. And then I've discovered that a lot of people are tied to my loins. I can't afford to waste them. It's mentality. Don't work with collection mentality. Exist as a giver. It's mentality. Poverty is in the mind before it is in the hand. Poverty is a disease of the mind, not a disease of the pocket. Give a poor man who is poor in mentality, give him 600 million, he will squander it. Will end up getting more women, end up getting to more hotels. A young man sold a land, 9 million. Sold one to me, 6 million. In less than 2 months, he sold a land. And the mother was telling me, I made up to 26 million. No one saw him again. He started lodging in a particular hotel. And guess what? He still has to go to the bush till now to go to toilet. Poverty is here, sir. Poverty is here, sir. Poverty is here, sir. A poor man is a waster. Watch it well. Either the person is a waster of resources, or a waster of opportunities, or a waster of precious relationships. They feel they are gods. They keep telling you, no man is my God. It's a lie, sir. Men are doors. Men are portals and channels. Somebody say here. Men are portals and channels. I'm not a receiver. I'm a giver. Yes, yes. You must exist with that mentality. Exist with that mentality. I'm not what? I'm not a receiver. I'm a giver. Rise to your feet wherever you are. Somebody say, I'm blessed.